radio picked up a station from the USA. And all the people heard just what occurred upon a program known as Giveaway. They had a lady win a diamond pin, a sable, and a brand new limousine. She took home all the loot and more to boot for knowing 12 and 5 or 17. That day in Mexico, the radio was heard by one whose name was Don Jose. He said, if that was Bozo on all those shows, I think I go for visit right away. He got his papers quick and then a ticket on a plane for Hollywood and Vine. He got to town at 8 and sure as fate, he wound up in a studio at 9. He knew that Mexico would hear the show and he was set to make his family proud. And so he whistled and he raised his hand and yelled until they picked him from the crowd. He got the biggest score and what is more, he even won the jackpot of the show. He blew his top because the price it was an airplane trip right back to Mexico. That's all, Marco. My throat is sore today. Will you call Lucy and tell her I'll be home right away?
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
Lucy?
Yeah?
Your new furniture came.
Really? What's it like?
I don't know. I was so busy, I just told her to put it all in the apartment. Oh, I'm just dying to see it. Oh, darn this key. You know, for the rent you charge, you could have bigger keyholes. There.
Oh, my gosh. You know, I think there's a little too much furniture in here. It does look a little overcrowded, doesn't it?
I forgot we had to take the old furniture out. Oh, well.
Gee, there's a lot of wonderful stuff, huh? Where's the phone? Yeah, it's not here.
Oh. Well, now, where is the phone?
Oh, for heaven's sake.
What could they do with it?
Let's see now, I was lying on the sofa talking.
It's on the floor or something.
Yeah, sounds like it, doesn't it?
Lucy!
Did you find it?
No.
Oh. Oh, here it is. For heaven's sake.
Oh, gosh.
Hello?
Oh, too late.
Now I'll never know who it was, and that drives me absolutely crazy.
Me too.
Gee. Hey, look at this stuff. Isn't it going to look wonderful?
Uh-huh.
Oh, look at that luscious chair.
Oh, boy.
Oh, Ethel, will you help me get the old stuff out? I'm dying to see how the room's going to look.
Where'll I put it?
Let's take it and put it out in the hall, all the old stuff.
Okay.
Here. Listen, you know, I'm not going to be able to leave that piano there. I'm going to put it over on that. Well, I want everything completely different, you know? There.
Oh, it just looks wonderful, Lucy.
Isn't it beautiful? I'm going to make an entrance from another room and see how it looks. Oh, this is the most beautiful room I've ever seen. Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
How do you like it?
Gee, this new stuff is marvelous.
Isn't it, though? Listen, Fred, would you do me a big favor? Would you take a few little pieces of furniture down in the basement for me?
Sure, where are they?
Right out here.
Few little pieces, huh?
Well, it's not very much. If you just move this over a little bit.
What's the matter?
What's the matter? Something moved! Something touched me! There's something alive in there!
Alive?
Yes, right there!
Oh, that's impossible.
It is not impossible. It's me! Fred, what's the big idea? This is the craziest thing I've ever seen yet. What's the idea of putting all the furniture on in the...
Well?
Oh, it's real nice, honey.
You don't like it.
Oh, yes, I do, honey, I do. It's just, I don't feel good today, honey. I feel real bad. I got a sore throat, and I think I'm catching a cold, everything.
Oh, you've been working too hard redecorating that club.
Yeah, maybe that is. Will you give me a couple of aspirins, honey?
Sure, dear, sure. Ethel, do you think I made a mistake putting that chair there? You know, my first impulse was to put the chair here, have the table on this
Lucy,
side.
Lucy, Lucy!
What?
Please, honey, I don't feel good. Get me the aspirins. I think I'm getting a streptococci.